I tried to track him down, and lo and behold, he just signed with Mickey Most. But he suggested Robert. So I tracked up to Birmingham and saw him, and I was amazed, you know, and suddenly it all started to come together in a very short time. It wasn't like a year's process of getting it all together, which seems to be the usual thing. I mean, the whole thing came together within a matter of weeks.
When you first saw Robert, can you remember your immediate reactions?
Yes, I do. It was very strange, actually. I thought there must be something wrong with this chap, because if he hasn't got on, because, you know, the quality of his voice was really, you know, striking. I thought it must just be a personality thing.
Right down inside.
So there he was singing away, and I thought, what an incredible voice. He must be a complete nutcase or something, you know. Why on earth hasn't he shot through? Why hasn't he made it through?
Gorgeous lady at the railway station. I thought, this can't be Jimmy, you know?
But it was. But true enough, yeah. A sight that I've seen many times since. In fact, I don't look so bad myself in drag. I met him at the door, and they thought I was a roadie, you know.
With his T-shirt on.
Yeah, I couldn't afford any nice clothes in those days. With a body like mine, I shouldn't have been wearing them anyway.
Is the variety of moods and musical expression that you and Jimmy and John Paul Jones and Bonzo seem to get into. You know, it's really evident at your concerts, because people seem to arrive at a Led Zeppelin gig at a very high emotional state, and then to present more than they're expecting is, to me, well, for lack of a better word, amazing.
I tell people as we start to play to be prepared to sit and listen to things that... you know, that, I mean, if there is an agitation in them and a desire to get up and wet one's knickers, then you can do that just as easily on something that doesn't immediately give you that impression musically, you know. It's not a whole lot of love from start to finish.
But I think that's been something that has been there for a long time.
Yeah.
Well, for us.
Yeah.
But I take it a group, because I remember when we played here in LA, and we played Stairway, and it hadn't come out. Mm-hmm. And I remember that they gave a standing ovation, which was really amazing. Mm-hmm. The point that it came in the act, you know.
Right,
it's very hard to hear songs the first time around, you know, and really get that much into them.
So it seems that now that people are able to sit down and get off at it, and at the end be very satisfied, because we've taken them through the realms of what we've been able to do. And that's the only reason that we're there now, is because, you know, the realms are so... They go from there... to there, 180 degrees. We still got another 180 to go.
Good evening.
let the dirt go, and she's buying the stairway to heaven. When she gets there, she knows if the stores are all closed, with a word she can get what she came for. You know sometimes words have two meanings. In a tree by the brook, there's a songbird who sings. Sometimes all of our thoughts are misgiven, and we know.
Some good news. If there's a bustle in
should have thank you.